So I quickly want to sort of introduce how virtualization actually helps us in limiting the damage that can be caused by a compromised or hacked operating system. Okay, we said maybe you want to run more than one operating system on the same underlying hardware, but this is going to help us with security as well. So limiting the damage of a hacked operating system, let's see, how can we do that when we have virtualization? Okay, the way we do that is we change the picture where, you know, we had the hardware and the operating system. Well, we introduce something between the hardware and the operating system, and that is called a hypervisor. On top of the hypervisor, we support what is called virtual machines, and these virtual machines have their own operating system. It's called the guest operating system, and the guest operating system then can support a number of applications that run within that virtual machine. So if we look at our earlier picture, we have the hardware, then we have the hypervisor, and then we have these virtual machines. So this is the OS here and the application here. Compromise of an OS here only affects these applications in this virtual machine. It doesn't do anything to the application that may be running in this different virtual machine with the same operating system or a different operating system. What we really have is isolation between virtual machines. So earlier we had isolation between processes or applications. Now, and you know, they all shared the same operating system. Now we have isolation between different virtual machines. Each has its own operating system, a guest operating system. So I can do my taxes in one virtual machine while browse potentially in dangerous places on the web in a different virtual machine. Okay, anything bad that happens in the second virtual machine of VM2 should not affect your tax stuff that you're doing on in your first virtual machine. So the trusted computing base really here is the hypervisor. The picture that we had before where we had, you know, the hardware and the trusted computing base and then the application, it changes with virtualization where we have the hardware, hypervisor, and then the virtual machines, and those virtual machines have their own operating system.